big guys get it done. Look at the production they got. The big three combining for 7 points in the 5-1 win here in game number five. We heard Nate MacKinnon after talking about, yeah, the big guys have to step up. You know what, hockey? It's a team effort, and that was a total team effort after that opening game. 4-0 loss, but after that, it was an avalanche, so to speak.
It truly was an avalanche. You could say the Flames got torched, to say the least.
Oh, bringing it.
That's all we could say, but honestly, after the first game in which the Avs got shut out 4-0, complete dominance, they outscored Calgary 17-7 in the next four games. Yes, there was a couple of overtime, 3-2 close games in there, but the reality is when the Avs needed to bring it, they just had another gear. There was no answer in Calgary for MacKinnon, Rantanen, Landeskog. Tyson Berry played amazing in this series, proved that he is the offensive guy. You know he is, but he also proved that he can defend. He played tremendous for me, and then you have to tip your cap to Colin Wilson as well tonight.
Collective effort, that's for sure. But MacKinnon called Rantanen an animal. How would you categorize the top three guys? Because at one point in the season, we were saying these top three, they're the best line in hockey.
They were beasts. When you think about Mikko Rantanen, you're talking about a guy that's 6'4", 220 pounds. Nathan MacKinnon, not so big, 6 feet. Oh, 205 pounds. Did I mention that?
He's a horse.
And how about Landeskog? He weighs in at about 215 pounds. He's only 6'1". There's a lot of beef there. These guys are tough to control.
What's this? Arby's? Where's the beef?
Where is the beef? It's all on that line. Not to mention Colin Wilson's a pretty thick kid himself, but it's not just beef. It's also speed.
Yeah.
It's power. It was dominance. This is a bit of a surprise, obviously. Not a lot of people were thinking that the Colorado Avalanche would be able to do this to a Calgary Flames team that finished second in the National Hockey League, 107 points. They had a remarkable season, but the Avs made it look easy in this round. They really did against them.
A good sign for the Avs and their fan base moving forward, because there were times during the season we were saying, does this team, yeah, they have the horses up front, those big three. Do they have enough depth? But how about in this deciding game five, Colin Wilson, as you mentioned, 3 points. Tyson Berry, as you mentioned, 3 points. Do they have enough depth moving forward now at this point? Have they proven that?
As long as all their big guys are healthy, they have plenty of scoring to move forward. A lot of their depth guys, the Matt Nietos, the Jost, you can go up and down their lineup.
Kale McCarr now.
A lot of these guys are making contributions in so many different ways that it just gives the Avalanche the appearance of a lot more depth than they probably really have. The fact of the matter is when your big line is going as good as theirs, you're just fine.
Yeah.
The Avalanche, to me, believe it or not, they're in like maybe the second inning in terms of their development. They have a long way
to
go, but they are really good already. This is going to be a great organization for years to come.